In this example, we'll look at cell growth in a batch reactor, and we're using in this case a bacteria to produce a product, P. The rate expression in this case depends on the concentration of cells, C sub C, and the concentration of substrate, the nutrients that are used for the growth of the cell. This is a rate constant, and this is another constant. So this, notice there's a negative sign here, so the rate of the substrate, we're actually going to see the amount of substrate decrease with time. We put a minus sign in front of it, so the term is positive. And then we also know for this system that for every gram of substrate that's consumed, a half a gram of cells form. And here are our initial concentrations. So our concentration of cells are relatively low, and the concentration of substrate is relatively high. The substrate, of course, is going to decrease, right? So the substrate concentration is going to decrease, and the cell concentration is going to increase. And the problem asks us to plot the concentration of the substrate and the concentration of cells as a function of time. We want to do this until we essentially use up all the substrate. It also asks to plot the rates as a function of time. And so the solution here is a standard batch reactor. A couple things that make it simple. Biological system and liquid phase, so it's constant volume. So the rate expression, the general form for a batch reactor, change in number of moles of C respect to time is the rate of reaction of C times the volume, and actually factor out the volume and cancel so we can write the rate. And then we can also write the rate of the concentration of substrate with time as the rate of the substrate reaction, which is minus U max concentration of substrate, concentration of cells of this constant, and the concentration of cells. So this is one differential equation. Now, if we remember that it says for every gram of substrate consumed, a half a gram of cells form. So that means we can write the rate of concentration of cell change. This R sub C is 0.5 times R sub S, but with a minus sign, so that we end up with rate expression 0.5 U max K plus CS. So notice the concentration C is on the right side, which says as we have more cells, the rate becomes faster. It's an autocatalytic behavior that we see with cell growth. So we have two differential equations, and we have initial conditions, namely at time equals zero, the concentration of C, 0.4 grams per liter, and the concentration of S, 15 grams per liter. So we have two ordinary differential equations. And this is an initial value problem. And so we can integrate these relatively straightforward. We know the values of the constants, K 0.10, and that's grams per liter, and mu max 0.5 hours of minus 1. So we're going to solve this using Polymath. It's relatively easy software that allows us to calculate these concentrations and rates as a function of time. So here's the Polymath program. We have the differential equation, writing in terms of RS for the cells, an initial condition, differential equation for the substrate concentration, and then remember a rate, respect to S, has a minus sign, and values of the constants will start at t equals zero, and from trial and error, we find that if we integrate up to 13 hours, then we've used up all of the substrate. And so here's the change in the substrate concentration with time, and it goes to zero after about 12 hours. And the cell concentration, you notice the rate is actually increasing until we run out of substrate. So in addition to the concentrations, we can ask Polymath to plot the rate. This is R sub S, which is negative, so the absolute value of the rate, if you like, is increasing. We're using up the substrate faster until we get to the highest rate of consumption, and then it starts dropping off rather quickly because we're using up the substrate. We don't have enough left, and eventually goes to zero, and so the rate of cell growth exact same shape, half the amplitude, and opposite sign. So by solving these differential equations, we can see how the rate's changing as a function of time before we use up all of the substrate.